My name is Shaesta Waiz. I'm the founder and president of Dream Store Incorporated. I'm currently flying solo around the world in a single-engine Beechcraft Bonanza to help inspire the next generation of science, technology, engineering, and math professionals. A little bit about my background. My family and I came from Afghanistan as refugees in 1987 during the Afghan-Soviet War. And I grew up in a family with five other sisters, so six girls at home. And I just thought to myself, I'm probably gonna get married at a young age and have a big family like my mom did. And it wasn't until I found aviation where my life completely changed. My educational background is quite interesting because I grew up very unmotivated. I grew up in a very underprivileged school district, and I just had no passion for education. And when I found aviation, all of that changed for me. And it was because of aviation I started to take more higher advanced math courses. My advice to middle school students is that no matter how far or unattainable your dreams may seem, they are very well within reach. And I remember thinking to myself that I'd love to be a pilot, but it's something that girls from Afghanistan don't do. And once I got past this way of thinking, and I just kind of looked at myself not as a Afghani woman, but I looked at myself as a person who has desires, who's just equal to any person out there in the world, and is equal to those who've accomplished many great things. As I started to think that way, I started to accomplish a lot more. And my big advice to middle school students is that approach life the way pilots do. That when you're sitting in the airplane doesn't know who you are, what your background is, but it propels you forward. One thing I've learned is with every failure, it's not really failure, it's just a way of the universe telling you this is not the direction you're supposed to go to. And instead of giving up whenever you come across failures or setbacks, just tell yourself this is not how it's supposed to be and look for another solution. Imagine for those pioneers in the past, if they would have just given up at the first sign of failure, what sort of life would we be living in?